There are heightened fears this morning about a big summer surge of the coronavirus. Tens of thousands of people are rolling into Sturgis, South Dakota this weekend for the annual motorcycle rally there. It's raising concerns that the event is becoming a super spreader and that it's being made more dangerous by the highly contagious Delta variant that has sent coronavirus infections across the country soaring. Missouri has been particularly hard hit by the Delta variant. New cases have climbed 14% over the last week. Hospitalizations are up 25%. Deaths increased by 28%. All of this as tempers flare over mask mandates. Mireya Villarreal reports.
With the rise of the Delta variant across the state of Missouri, Kansas City reinstated their mask mandate this week. And Lotta Williams, general manager at the ship, took it one step further.
They decided to implement a vaccine or proof of negative COVID test within 48 hours of the show on the nights that we have live entertainment. It's not an exclusionary thing so much as it is just trying to keep from going to another shutdown of being able to have live music.
Kansas City hit their highest positivity rate of COVID cases since the pandemic began at 34.4%. Fully vaccinated rates are just below 40%, prompting Mayor Quentin Lucas and the city to take action.
The entire state of Missouri, every one of our 114 counties, is a hotspot zone for COVID-19. So we saw it was important for us to act, given that updated guidance from not just the CDC, but our health department, and that's why we have a mask mandate today.
The mandate requires masks must be worn in all indoor spaces where 6 feet cannot be maintained. Further east, St. Louis County also tried to reinstate their mask mandate and was sued by the Missouri Attorney General. 2 days after Kansas City's mandate went into effect, the AG sued the city and Mayor Lucas. The AG posting on Twitter, the mask mandate is an orchestrated distraction, and the restrictions are not about science, but about politics.
Are you trying to infringe on the freedoms of people that live in the city?
You know, what I'm trying to do is make sure that we can stay open. He doesn't care about the outbreak in our community. There are too many people in this state and in this country who right now, when we are dealing with a real crisis, have chosen, I think, to divide us further.
That political division now playing out inside local hospitals. Nurse Rachel Johnson has patients from the same family dying on her floor.
In the last year, yeah, I've seen more death than in the whole other 7 years of my career combined. Do what you can. Like I said, even if it's not going to affect you, it's going to affect somebody.
Hospital doctors are saying a lot of their new patients are coming in unvaccinated, and a number of them are younger and with more severe disease. Hospitals are also turning people away, saying if you think you have COVID, we don't have room for you, and you need to go to your primary care specialist. For CBS This Morning, Saturday, Mireya Villarreal in Kansas City, Missouri.